day has been long already.
Our drone was not built for the heavy rain that we experienced this morning.
The weather has been playing havoc with our Wi-Fi.
We cut up ponchos, started wrapping it up.
We have a scout that barely works, and we have a package delivery drone that, look, we don't even know if it can fly.
Man, it's gonna be something.
We are here at Accelevate in Leesburg, Virginia today for the East Region Autonomous Vehicle Competition, which consists of five universities. We have Howard University, George Mason University, George Washington University, University of Southern Florida, and Virginia Tech competing.
Everybody will get a real life experience at Accelevate. We have to shift often if we get rain, and today we definitely got a lot of rain.
We had looked ahead of time and seen that it might have been raining today, and so we put together a couple hats for the drone.
Landscape is also a very large factor. It's a little bit more hilly here than what the students are used to.
I think our drone got destroyed four or five times because landing here, we got caught in grass.
It really helps show the importance of a robust design.
This year's competition consists of air vehicles and ground vehicles and a search and rescue mission.
The drone is going to search for a aerial marker, and once it's identified that, you're going to send a signal to either another drone or you have a ground vehicle, one or the other, which is going to deliver a care package over to the aerial marker and try to deliver it as close to it as possible.
We had to be on our toes today. We had to, you know, use our intuition, use our engineering grit.
There's been a couple instances where we've been ready to go, ready to go, ready to go. And then as soon as we get the judges there, there's some issue.
One of the biggest challenges they have to do is work out the communications between the two different vehicles, which is sometimes very challenging, especially if they operate in different domains.
When you're actually on the field, there's a lot of being quick on your feet, being able to adapt to new situations.
We were really like nervous about it, but it seemed like everything was kind of coming together. It's like, we just need that one thing to work.
Because I want to.
What I love about being a mentor is that the excitement of when something works for the students. I see the hard work that they put into it, and getting that like light bulb when it finally comes all together.
It's a safe space to fail. Except all the problems are exactly the same problems they're gonna face in the real world. So just seeing how they adapt is very important.
Raytheon investing in competitions like this one is incredibly important to our future because this is the future of our workforce.
We get the chance to actually teach them things, how to solve a real world problem outside of our classroom.
Teaches you a lot about like the teamwork and communicating with others.
Being able to manage projects, being able to participate, being a part of a team, knowing what your team's names are.
Keep pushing through and learning how to adapt as best as you can and showing that you have passion.
We're so used to working on separate projects that we don't really think, how is this going to connect to somebody else's project? As we started working more together as a team, everything got so much better.
Third place award goes to George Mason University.
This competition is a fantastic gateway to the industry. I really, really appreciate that Raytheon sponsors and puts on this competition.
Our second place award goes to Virginia Tech, and our first place award goes to the University of South Florida.
I just want to say thank you for including the University of South Florida. We're super appreciative of this competition and everything that we've learned from it, and we just hope that that continues.